The King Eternal Monarch. A good drama, a good story, and I would definitely recommend this drama to anyone who has not seen it. It had everything going for it. An all-star cast, a budget, the hype, a really good screenwriter. So why did it struggle? So I've been reading a few articles about this drama, why it had low ratings, why it struggled, why it didn't do so well. And I even came across an article about other Korean drama producers' opinion about this drama. And I was trying to nitpick some stuff for me to talk about. I'm not going to talk about the whole thing. But just some stuff for me to talk about, agree on, and I want to know your guys' opinion too. So the first one is slow pace. That one I can agree on. I don't know when it happened, but when the drama was trying to introduce us to new characters, it came to a point where I was asking myself, even though I didn't say it on camera when I was doing my review, why should I care about this character? Is this character just going to be a one and go? Is this character going to have an important role? Even if that character is just a third party character, why should I care about it? So again, they've been introducing us to new characters almost probably half of the episodes. So again, it was coming to a point where, okay, that's a lot of characters. Why should I care about them? And I know I sound like a broken record player, but I mean, that's just how I feel. And also, there were some parts in certain episodes where they were considered, to me, filler. Where, okay, I'm like, okay, so that scene is not really needed, so why is it in there anyway? And it doesn't really relate to the relationship between Egon and Tae-il, or the story in general. So again, slow pace, I get it. Now number two, the controversies. Boy, this is interesting. And I want to know your guys' opinion too. I remember the first article that came out, and it was about the Japanese flag. And I think the Japanese flag was on a fictional Korean empire. I get it, the history between Japan and Korea, you know, with World War II back in 1910. Japan was trying to colonize Korea and using Korean women as sex slaves. So I'm not going to sit here and try to understand how they're feeling towards anything Japan related in a Korean drama, but I will say this, I understand why they don't like it. And another Japanese related is a Japanese warship with the Japanese flag. It looks similar to the current Korean one. So again, I'm not going to sit here and pretend that I understand, but I do understand why. Number three, the competition. Wow. Oh yeah, also, if I'm looking back and forth like this, it's because I'm also looking at the article and reading some of the stuff that I typed down to make sure I'm saying everything because I don't want to leave anything out. So again, number three, the competition. The other drama that also aired during the weekend, The World of the Married. Oh my god. If you guys haven't seen it yet, I highly, highly recommend watching it. You'll understand why it became a huge success. You'll understand why it beat Sky Castle. And you'll understand why a lot of people, even critics, like this drama. It is really, really good. I don't want to spoil anything. Like, I don't even want to just give the smallest detail. But I will say this. It is fast-paced. And a lot of things is going to happen all at once. So I highly recommend watching it. Now, there are other factors on why the drama didn't do so well, but this is just other people's opinions. So one of them is product placement. Now, the thing about product placement, well, for me, if it doesn't distract me from the actual storyline and it doesn't distract me from watching the episode, I'm okay with that. But to some people, it may be annoying, it may be distracting, I get it, but I guess it depends on who you are. But for me, again, I'm okay with product placement just as long as it doesn't distract me. And for The King, it didn't. And the next one is having high expectations. Now, because the screenwriter is Kim Eun-suk, who also wrote Descendants of the Sun, I recommend watching that if you haven't yet. I get it of having high expectations, and probably some people didn't like it because they were expecting more, but they got what they got with The King. For me, I wasn't really expecting much, That's not to say that I'm not a fan of Kim Min-soo. I'm actually a fan because I'm also a fan of Descendants of the Sun. But when I'm watching a new drama, yes, I want to know who's in it. Yes, I want to know the genre, and I want to read the general description of that genre. But after reading the description and knowing who's in it, I don't really expect much because I don't want my expectations to be shattered. Because if you expect something more than what it is, obviously you're going to be disappointed. So when you enter a, so when you start watching a new drama and enter their world, don't like try to not expect anything big, even if there are big names in this drama from the producers, the screenwriters, or even the actors. Just try not to expect much. Just only expect to enjoy the drama. But this is just my opinion though. So my thoughts on this drama, and I'm gonna sound like a broken record player for those who have seen my reviews, have already know that I've been enjoying this drama from beginning to end. Yes, there were some cons as well as pros, but overall, I've been enjoying this drama and I've been enjoying the actors portraying their characters. This type of story, I would consider it unique, but it's not something new. Having different universes has been done before. I mean, you got other dramas like Goblin, W, Chicago Typewriter, Circle, Two Worlds Connected. Like, those dramas also had different universes. So again, it's unique, but it's not something new. Also, I did not forget about the article of Korean producers' opinions about this drama. I'm pretty much just scanning through, and I'm reading some of their quotes. One producer said it's a failure. There is no arguing that. That's a little much. The product placement are ridiculous. I can't imagine what the international fans will think of it when they watch it on Netflix. I am a international fan, but it doesn't really bother me. There is no way this series could have done well. There is absolutely no chemistry between the lead roles. They all suck at acting. Okay, that's a little too much. I wouldn't go as far as saying they suck at acting. I thought their acting was pretty good. But on the other hand, I'm not a Korean drama producer, and I'm pretty sure that these Korean drama producers have produced more than five dramas, I guess, and I've produced zero. So, I mean, it's a fan's opinion and a producer's opinion, so. I mean, can't really say much about that. You know, I'll just end it here because I don't want to go too much. So, did you guys like the drama too? Did you guys like it? Hate it? You thought it was okay? Did you only watch it because Lee Min-ho was in it? Leave your comments down below, and if you guys like this video, leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe. Please subscribe, and see ya.